I did it!
Woke up and my dad was like, hey, we're gonna go to breakfast in like 10 minutes, so get ready. So I got ready as fast as I can. And we're going to breakfast, and it's really sad because this is our second to last day, so we're leaving tomorrow. And I don't wanna leave. I'm really sad. So something crazy just happened, literally crazy, like I would never think that would happen in my whole entire life. But so like I said, you guys saw we were going to breakfast at just like this little breakfast place on like the shore. And so we get there, we're standing in line, and I'm just kind of like checking out these bracelets and stuff. They had some really cute bracelets, so we were just like trying on stuff. And then so then everybody, like, you just like hear kind of like a little alarm or like siren kind of thing, and I thought it was coming from the restaurant, but I don't think it was. I think it was just coming from all of our phones. And we got this alert right here. Here, I'll show you it. And it says, ballistic missile threat inbound to Hawaii, seek immediate shelter, this is not a drill. So that first one right there. So we got that on our phones, and first I didn't have my phone. It was just in my back pocket, so I didn't really know what was going on. And I was thinking like a tsunami or something, or like maybe like a hurricane. Well, I guess there's no like, I don't know, there's no like rain or anything, like it's nice weather. So I was just really confused because everybody started running after that siren. Like everybody was looking at their phones and like trying to find everyone, like who they were with and stuff. And like everyone was just like running, but I didn't know where they were running and stuff. And so then I looked at my phone. Or actually, no, then I just tried to find my mom and dad because I saw my mom, but I didn't know where my dad was. So I went and found my dad. And then we just kind of started like running, I guess, like with the crowd wherever they were going. And then I looked at my phone, and I think nobody said anything, but everybody just like was looking at their phone, and then we all knew what was going on. And that was probably like the scariest moment in my whole entire life. Like we didn't even know what to do because like, I don't know, there was nowhere we could go, and there were no like shelters or anything, and like Hawaii isn't really like prepared for that type of thing, I guess. And so what we did is we just ran to our van, and we just started like going really fast, and we tried to like find a police station or like something, like a fire station or anything, just like to maybe get word on what's going on and like what to do. So then we found a police station, and everybody's just like driving crazy, like we almost got hit by a car. And then everybody's like, go, go, go. And so then we went to the police station, and we talked to a policeman. They were all just kind of like hanging out in the parking lot, like letting people know what was going on. And then he said that civil defenses, they don't know why the alert was put out. He was like, we don't really know for sure what's going on right now. What we're hearing right now is like, there is no missile in the sky or en route to us right now. That's what civil defenses was saying. And they don't know if it is a false alarm. They don't know why the alert was put out, but they just know that like the missile wasn't heading toward us right now. So they didn't know if it was going to or if it wasn't going to. They're just saying like, kind of cross your fingers. And then so I started looking at Twitter, and then lots of people
seek shelter and pray.
Yeah, they said to seek shelter and pray. That's like what they told us to do. They were like, sorry, we don't really know what to tell you. So then I started looking at Twitter because I was freaking out. We were all freaking out because like, I don't know, that's scary, like really scary. And so then I was looking at Twitter, and I saw that people were just saying like, it could be a false alarm because there weren't actually any sirens going off, because they did like a few tests earlier this year, because like when the missile threat was like just kind of being talked about, so they did like a few tests and stuff on sirens. And so yeah, and then I looked at Twitter, and then we got this notification on our phone. That was the second notification, and then it said, there is no missile threat or danger to the state of Hawaii. Repeat, false alarm. So then we were like, okay, we're good. But I'm just saying, like, man, that was like scary. Like, I didn't know what to do. I started crying. I don't know, that was just really scary, and I never would have ever thought that would happen in my whole entire life. So
it was a false alarm.
Yeah, good thing it was a false alarm, and good thing we're safe. We're gonna go eat breakfast now.
Literally everyone is in shock here. Like, we were just talking to our waitress, and she said she was like heading home. Sorry, the lighting's really weird. She said that she was heading home, and she lives with like three roommates, and that she was about to move, and then she didn't know what to do. And she was like, my mom was right, like I should have moved back home. It's just so crazy that it happened. Like, it doesn't feel like it really happened. Feels like it's like a movie or something. So weird. It's so hot in here. We're just looking at little shops and stuff. It's really cute over here. Thought I would show you guys. Look how cute it is. It's all like colorful. We got a van store. And then the ocean's right over there. We got a cute little St. Christopher pendant. Oh, I don't know if it's focusing. I don't know if you can really see it. But it's supposed to help you with travels, and I guess to like get back or whatever. So yeah, and we definitely need that after today. So funny. So I literally turned around a corner and I was like, I really want henna, because earlier I saw like a little festival in the park and I was wondering if they did henna. So I literally turned the corner and I'm like, I need to find somewhere that does henna. And then literally I look to my right and there's somewhere that does henna. So I'm just trying to figure out what I want. So yeah, I think that I'm gonna do like a smaller one, because I'm probably gonna get in the water a little bit later and you have to stay out of the water for a minute. So yeah, so I'm getting a henna right now. I'm gonna get like a little wave with the like sun, and then I want to put Maui and cursive underneath it. It literally took like 5 minutes. Super,
like, say things
fast,
like,
super easy. Yeah, not even 5 minutes, huh? But now I'm gonna just sit in the fan. Then we're probably gonna get some shaved ice. Got another shaved ice. I guess this one's supposed to be like the best on the island. Well, not like this location, but like this place is supposed to be like the best shaved ice on the island. It's called Ululani's Gourmet Hawaiian Shaved Ice. I'll let you guys know. So now we're at Bubba Gump's. We're gonna get some lunch. I don't even know what I want. Well, obviously like shrimp or something. I don't know. We just found a license plate on the ceiling over there, because they have a bunch of license plates everywhere. We found a Utah one. Look how pretty it is. Like a random tree in the middle of the restaurant, and we just barely realized this. Look how cool. That's so cool.
Monkey pod tree.